Hello everyone, welcome back to JustMarvel.com. I'm back with another video tutorial. Here, in this video, I'm going to tell you how to implement data tables in your Marvel applications server-side. In the previous videos, I told you how to implement data tables in your applications client-side. Here, I'm going to tell you how to implement them in the server-side. I've also mentioned you about the advantages of using server-side when you have two sets of data, because when you use client-side, all the data is loaded at once. Hundreds of records, thousands of records, even lakhs of records. But when we use server side, we can only load limited set of records. Like if we can paginate a few records in a page, and if we go to the next page, the other records will load. That's one of the main things we use server side implementation of data tables. So let's get started.
So let me open up my terminal first. I'm in my folder here. I'll create a new Laravel project using Composer create command. I'll also specify the Laravel version 6, and I'll give the name as data table server side. And I'll create the application here. You can see, guys, it's installed. So let me open this in my Sublime text editor. I'll go to CD data tables server side. Also, I will run this application using PHP addition serve. It's running in localhost 8000. So this is the default page given by Laravel. If you see this, that means our application is running successfully. So what I'll do here is, I already created a client-side application. Client-side application in previous tutorials, I'll just copy the HTML structure, the tables and all. I will just explain here how to implement it in server-side, the server-side things. And remaining everything will be the same, the HTML tables, the models, the connection, everything will be the same. Also, the database I used here in that previous tutorial is this table, data tables data. I will also use the same database here. So I have created this basic table here. This is the table head with ID, first name, last name, gender, country, salary, and there will be some action buttons here for edit and delete. So when click, it will show a pop-up for edit, and in that pop-up we can edit the details of this. And when delete is clicked, it will also show up a pop-up like, are you sure you want to delete this person? And if you see, guys, there will be no body here. Body will be generated dynamically. We just need to give the table head an empty table body. So I gave this ID of data table here. So later in the script here, I will initialize data tables with this ID so that it automatically fills up this body element. So also in the controller, I'll see I have created a function index, and there is nothing here. In the previous client-side application, we will just use this all method, and it will fetch us all the it, and it will show us, and it will give us all the details, default root file. And I also created this model in app folder, data.php. This is the table I've shown you earlier, and I've disabled this timestamps. So now if we go to the browser and see, it looks like this, just the table with no data here. So to get the data and to process it server side, first let us define this function here. Here, instead of using this, this will be in the client side. So instead of returning this data, or you return the same but with data tables. Like this, return data tables of data all. So end with this, and I will make them using this make true. So this will give us the data we need. So again, in this view, so here, so I can initialize. So I have initialized data tables like this. This is the ID which I've gained for the table, and we'll just call data table on it. And now we need to tell them that it is server side, So I'll give server side equal to true, and also I have to tell them that processing is also true. Now I said server side equal to true, so I need to call a server side URL for this, and we'll use AJAX, and I'll use AJAX here. I'll make an AJAX call, and I'll call an AJAX URL that will call this function here, and it will return the data. So let me call the AJAX URL now. I made the URL as server side, so I need to create this URL in the web.php file. Root, I can create this as get itself. The URI is server side, and I'll create a and there is also a data controller. And the function is index. This is the function. We'll call this function here. It will return all the database, and it will make the data tables. So after calling the AJAX URL, I need to define the columns, and that means in which column which data should be placed, like columns, and here in columns I need to tell for ID what is the value to be taken from that, and for first name what is the value to be taken from this result. Similarly for all this, I will remove the actions for now. We have not yet defined the actions. So here in this columns array, we will give data. The first one is ID, and the next one is first name, these are the values for each column here. These names, first name, ID, these first underscore name, ID, last underscore name, these names are coming from the result here. If you print the result, the value for this will be stored in these variables. So I'm printing those. I'm setting those values to these columns here. Similarly for all other fields, ID, first name, last name, email, gender, country, and salary. So before running this application, guys, a small note here in this. This is a plugin we are using, Jira Data Tables, and it says we shouldn't use this PHP Artisan serve. They're suggesting us to use some local server and host there, so I have done that. Until now we are using this PHP Artisan serve. So what I'll do is, so I'll just transfer this application to some local, I'll create a virtual host, create the application there. I've already created a virtual host here. This is the virtual host. I've created this virtual host as data table server side to test, and on this port 8088. And I moved the application from my local drive to XAMPP htdocs, and this is the host file. I have given this localhost, I have given this domain here. So now I can go to datatable server side dot test, and we can continue from there. So I moved everything to XAMPP htdocs. So this is the welcome.update.php file. These are the things we have done. We have called this server side, and it will call this data tables function, and it will show all the data. And we have a table here with an ID, and we have initialized data tables here. We are getting data from this XURL. So let me now save this and run in the browser. You can see this, the data is shown. These are the 987 records I have in this database. The pagination is working. You can see the ID changed from 23 to 32. If I go to the page 5, it shows from 53 to 62. It is showing 10 entries. Now it shows 25. It will show 25 entries. Every time it says processing, it fetches the data from the database. And we can sort the email, sort the columns by letters, numbers. You can also search. I'll search for Mary. There are any one with Mary. You can see all the ones with Mary are shown. So basically, we are getting the data from server side, AJAX call, and it calls internal PHP function. We are getting data from that. And this is the server side implementation. And as mentioned, I will also create an actions button, actions here, actions column here. I will add edit and delete options. When clicked on it, it will show up a pop-up similar to what I have done in client side. You can see the client side applications, the features will be similar. When clicked on edit, all the data will be shown in a pop-up, and we can edit there, and if you click on update, the data will be updated immediately and will be reflected in this row. Similarly for delete, when you click on delete, it will ask for a pop-up, confirmation pop-up, and if we say yes, it will be deleted immediately, and that will also be reflected here in the page without refreshing. So basically what I've done is, these are all the these are all the basic CSS files for Bootstrap data tables, and these are the JS files for jQuery data tables, Bootstrap. I also used a JS for responsiveness. So these are the basic things for using these data tables, and I've created table, basic HTML table. I have given an ID of data table, and I've initialized that ID with data table. I have set processing equal to true, server side equal to true, and I call this AJAX URL server side. Here it gives us this data of this model. Here you can also see the model, this data table's data. So with that data, I'm showing the results in this table. So next I'll get an actions button here, and I also need to create actions here. And there will be some change in this function here. We need to add a few settings here so that the buttons will appear. That will be the next part. So that's it for this video.
Hi once again. Hope you liked the video. If you like it, please consider subscribing to the channel. That will help me a lot. Also, don't miss on the next part of this video. I'm going to add some action buttons to the column, edit and delete. That will be useful for the table and the data. Stay tuned for more videos from justnarul.com. See you in the part 2 of this video. Bye-bye.